I'm Andy from Yamaha Commercial Audio. Thanks for watching these Rivage video logs. This time, I'm talking about port-to-port patching. Since the introduction of version 2, one Rivage DSP R10 engine can connect to four separate networks via its HY slots on the rear panel. Slots 1 and 2 can both host twin lane cards, either using single mode or multi-mode fiber, and each can receive 256 channels and transmit 256 channels at 96 kHz, 32-bit. At the same time, slots 3 and 4 can both host Dante cards, each receiving and transmitting 144 channels at 96 kHz. Add to that the local I/O of the DSP engine and the console, and you have an input count higher than 850, all in a 5U rack unit. But consider the networks. Each twin lane network can have up to 8 I/O units with 96 micro-amps each, and can carry 400 channels, while each Dante network can have literally thousands of devices connected, with each 1 gigabit link cable able to carry around 250 channels at 96 kHz. That has almost unimaginable scale and potential. But the point of the port-to-port facility is to link input connections to output connections without passing through any of the mixer's channels. And there are three different levels at which to do that. With Dante, most users will already know that Dante controller software allows any transmitter to be routed to any receiver within the network, so long as they are operating at the same sample rate. It's easy to see that type of routing can bypass the DSP engine's mixer. The second level of patching is within one twin lane ring. This was already possible with version 1.5 firmware for Rivage. See the port-to-port page in the patch menu, and select any RPIO unit's input to patch directly to any RPIO output. And now, with the free version 2 update, we have the third level of patching with the new slot bridge. This is for easy transfer of audio from one network to another. Yes, even from twin lane to Dante. The slot bridge can take up to 36 channels from each HY slot and also from the local I/O of the DSP and console, and transfer them to any other HY slot. So it's an additional 180 by 180 patching matrix. So if you have a multi-room performance center with a different network for each room, you can easily set up communication lines and audio transfers between each system. For example, you might have a podium mic on stage connected to an RPIO, which obviously will be mixed to the PA system. But the raw signal can be transferred to Dante and onto a language translation booth, or another example in a TV station with multiple studios. There could be a chat show in a small studio using Dante, and that could link to a large studio using Twin Lane for a live music stage. A feed from the chat studio could be sent via Dante, bridged to the twin lane by the DSP in the control room, and then sent to a monitor on stage, so the musicians will be able to clearly hear their cue to start playing. So here's how it looks on the console. In the patch menu and the port-to-port tab, show the HY1 patch, and then select which inputs are going to send to the slot bridge. Then we look at the slot bridge patch and see the channels we just patched are labeled so. Now we choose where to send those channels. Now remember, HY3 in the PM10 is the main Dante network and HY4 is the Dante multi-track recording slot. So we will patch to HY3. Finally, we go to the HY3 patch page and we select where the bridge channels are going to end up. Now it's good to remember the multi-patch shortcut when dealing with many channels at the same time. Port-to-port patching is also available on the PM7, where the DSP is included in the console. In that case, only slot 1 can be used with twin lane, while Dante can occupy HY slots 2 and 3. Port-to-port is a great problem solver and time saver when routing audio around complex systems with multiple locations for audio inputs and outputs. Yamaha's RIVAGE systems are among the most versatile in the world, and yet they are still quite easy to use and understand. Look out for the other vlogs about the amazing new version 2 upgrade and the new, more affordable PM7 console.